This problem is going to use the energy equation to find head loss in a non-circular duct. Usually when we talk about head loss, we talk about it in a pipe, which is round. But here we're going to use a duct that is 6 inches by 12 inches on the side. So basically what it looks like is 6 by 12. So let's start with the governing equation for head loss. And head loss is found by multiplying the friction factor times the length of the pipe over the diameter times the average velocity squared over 2 times gravity. So in this case, we have galvanized iron pipe and we have standard air, and that flows at a volumetric flow rate of 5 feet cubed per second. The length of the pipe that we're interested in is 20 feet. Let's put together our plan. So the first thing, looking at our governing equation, is we need to figure out our average velocity, which is Q over A. What makes this different, because it's a non-circular duct, is that we have to use a hydraulic diameter, which is defined as 4 times the area divided by the perimeter. And in our case, it's 2 times the width times the length over the width plus the length. Once we find the velocity, we have the length, we have the hydraulic diameter, we're going to have to find the friction factor. And the friction factor is a function of the roughness of the pipe divided by the hydraulic diameter as well as the Reynolds number. So in order to find the friction factor, we're going to have to look up the roughness of galvanized iron, and we're going to have to calculate our Reynolds number, which is the velocity times the hydraulic diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. First, we will find our hydraulic diameter, which is 2 times 0.5 feet, which is our 6 inches, times 1 foot, which is our 12 inches, divided by 0.5 plus 1, or 1.5 feet. And that ends up being 0.67 feet. Next, we need to find our average velocity, which is our Q, 5.0 feet cubed per second, divided by our area, which is 0.5 feet, times 1 foot, and that equals 10 feet per second. Now, there are a number of charts that give roughness factors. In this case, we look up the roughness factor for galvanized iron, and we find that that equals 0.0005 feet. And again, it's a function of this roughness factor, our friction factor, is divided by the hydraulic diameter. And so this is 0.00075. The next thing we need to do is calculate our Reynolds number. And so that's our average velocity, which is 10 feet per second. Again, we have to use, instead of diameter, our hydraulic diameter, which is 0.67 feet. And we look up the kinematic viscosity in standard conditions, and that's 1.57 times 10 to the minus 4th feet squared per second. And when we calculate this, we get a Reynolds number of 4.3 times 10 to the 4th. So what does it mean that the friction factor is a function of this roughness factor and the Reynolds number? Well, in order to find the friction factor, we use what's known as the Moody chart. And what the Moody chart gives us is, based on both this roughness factor and this Reynolds number, we are able to use the chart and look up a friction factor. And in this case, our friction factor is 0.024. Now we're ready to calculate the head loss. Again, it's the friction factor times the length of the pipe divided by the hydraulic diameter times the average velocity squared divided by 2 times gravity. So that's 0.024 times 20 feet over 0.67 feet times 10 feet per second squared divided by 2 times 32.2 feet per second squared. And when we do the calculations, we find out that the head loss for this 20-foot length of our non-circular duct is 1.1 foot.